I'm David, a developer relations engineer at Google. In this video, I'm going to talk about and show you the key core concepts around spaces, groups, and memberships in Google Chat. Google Chat spaces are a great way to collaborate with your team. You can use them to have conversations about specific projects, to share files and documents, and to assign tasks. Click on the spaces icon to show the spaces to which you already have access. When you create a space, you're creating a new chat room. Messages in the space are accessible to all members, and files and tasks can be added and assigned to any member. The chat section of Google Chat is where you will find direct messaging and more informal groups of participants, along with direct notifications from apps installed in Google Chat, as you can see here. Group chats are a less formal version of a space and cannot have files or tasks. They can, however, be converted into spaces at a later time, if need be, as you can see here. This then allows them the full access to all chat rooms and spaces, so they can now have files and tasks. With the Chat REST API, you can either act as a service account and perform actions programmatically, or as a user. To perform any of the create or delete actions on spaces, you must act as the user. Using the spaces command, you can list all the available spaces and create, delete, update, and fetch individual spaces. For example, to list all the spaces available to a user, you would execute the spaces list command in the API as shown here. These results are returned as a paginated list of space objects, giving you all the information about the space concerning its configuration. Individual spaces can then be fetched using the spaces get command, provided you already know the name. To create a space using the API, you have two options: spaces create, which creates a space with just you in it, and spaces setup, which creates a space and allows you to pre-add up to 20 initial members. These members can be either users or apps. Spaces can be created as one of three types: a space, a group chat, or a direct message. This is set in the space type field, cannot be changed later, with the sole exception that a group chat can, as mentioned earlier, be converted into a space. Once you know the space's name, you can now maintain the membership using the API. You can list, delete, or get the details of current members or create new members. These all use the spaces members command API endpoints. You can also use the API to create and send messages. Messages can be as simple as a single line of text sent to a space, group, or DM, or as complex as a pop-up dialogue to gain information from a user using the cards framework. Check out the other videos in this series to see more about messaging using the API. Hopefully, this video has given you an idea of what the Spaces API can be used for. Please check out the links below this video for more resources and samples to help you further. Also, hit that like button if you've learned something new in this video, and remember to subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos about Google Workspace development.